Last night, police announced a change of venue where the National Unity Platform will hold its rally in Mukono District today. The development comes a day after they were cleared to resume their mobilization tour. Kampala Metropolitan Deputy Police Spokesperson Luka Wasijide said the venue for today's rally was changed from Njogeza Playground to Ntawo Playground after a meeting with the District Security Council. He revealed that the leadership of the NUP party had been duly informed of these changes. Yesterday, NUP party leaders, together with the security team from Mukono, toured several venues where NUP party president Robert Kyagulanyi Ssentamu was expected to address his supporters today. However, during the assessment, police okayed the entire playground, which angered the party leaders. This comes in the wake of the Monday meeting between police and NUP leadership, led by the leader of opposition in Parliament, Joel Senyonyi, and Party Secretary General Louis Rubongoya at the police headquarters in Kampala. On the other hand, Internal Affairs Minister Kahindo Tafire cautioned police against blocking mobilization activities by the opposition, especially NUP, as this is against the law.
So tell Kyagulanyi, tell VSJ, tell I don't know who the other one can say, if you want to do your meeting, don't do it on the street, don't do it in the market, don't do it in a school, don't do it in... Show him where to go. Say, if you want to make noise, go to Kororo. Go and jump up and down. When you are tired, you go home.
The Uganda Bureau of Statistics has revealed that preliminary findings of the 2024 census results will be released on June 24th. Although these results will be provisional in nature, they reveal the country's population by sex, age, religion, tribe and clan, and by level of education. The entity's executive director, Dr. Chris Mokiza, said the results will be according to district and sub-county level findings. This will be followed by more provisional results on September 24th and the final report on December 24th. Mokiza made the revelations yesterday during a press conference at Statistics House in Kampala. He added that preliminary findings show that they managed to reach 99% of the people targeted and that those who miss to be enumerated have a chance to be counted this Friday. On the other hand, Busoga region was found to have the most number of groups who made it difficult to be counted. Many of these belong to religious cults that don't believe in being counted. And in foreign news, South African voters turned out for a landmark general election today morning, with the ruling ANC's exclusive grip on power in doubt 3 decades after the advent of democracy. Some 27 million voters registered for the most uncertain poll since the African National Congress led the nation out of the apartheid rule, with opposition challenges from both the left and right. In Soweto, the former black township that became the unofficial capital of the liberation struggle, elderly voters still loyal to the ANC turned out early for a station that opened 15 minutes late.
Ukhongolose ke kuphume embusweni wase South Africa. Uma kuphela ukuthi mangabe abavoti bengavota kakhulu mhlambe kumkhonto wesizwe, amandla angehla ukhongolose. Kodwa yobe uyingxenye yombuso ngobe mhlambe mangabe amavoti awe eba unumber 2 kumkhonto wesizwe noma sembe kwi-DA noma imaphi.
In today's election, voters will choose the 400 members of the National Assembly, and these MPs will then go in the coming weeks to choose a president from among their number. Candidates for South Africa's 9 provincial assemblies are also on the ballot. For the first time since the advent of democracy in 1994, the ANC could be forced to negotiate a coalition in order to remain in government.
Kube neqembu elifikile la Africa kakhulu iEFF ukube ngangiyixoki ngangaxoma ngihlale kuyona yezwa lonto kodwa ngama noANC uphindile manje kwafika iMK still ngisamile noANC even if kuthiwa uANC usuyi opposition party angithi njengamanje uyi ruling party kusho ngathi uANC usuyi opposition party I will stand with uANC
under the leadership of the late Nelson Mandela. The ANC won freedom for black South Africans after decades of apartheid, then lifted millions out of poverty by creating a broad social welfare system.